It was forged during the Great Depression by a fiddler named Bob Wills. It came smoking out of the heartland and sizzled on our nation's radio. Now, more than 60 years later, a whole new generation of fans has discovered Western Swing. Hi, I'm Red Steagall. Join myself, Ray Benson, Asleep at the Wheel, Stonehorse, and Tracy Byrd for a remarkable new special, Still Swingin'.
Howdy, everybody, even way down yonder. Come on up here and get closer to us. It'll be warmer.
It was on February 9th, 1934, that a simple Texas fiddler named Bob Wills first took to the airwaves from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
We'll keep warm. We haven't picked that first bale of cotton yet, and we haven't got any.
He might not have known it back then, but he was about to make history. For he and his band, the Texas Playboys, were about to use the miracle of radio to introduce the world to a whole new form of music. It was called Western Swing. Forged in the Great Depression, formed during America's Dust Bowl, it came out smoking. It sizzled daily from the Canes Ballroom over mighty clear channel radio station KVOO, filling a depression-weary country with soul-stirring, foot-tapping musical joy.
Oh, it won't be long now. Little bees up the blossom, big bee gets the honey, dark he raise the cotton, white man gets the money.
Take me back, Delta, I'm too young to marry. Take me back.
That Texas fiddler is gone now. But after more than a half a century, the music he created is still swinging.
Live from Canes Ballroom, the home of Western Swing, KVOO proudly presents a Sleep with the Wheels tribute to Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys. Ladies and gentlemen, Asleep at the Wheel!
Yes, take me back to Tulsa!
Today, some 60 years after Bob Wills first took to this very stage, Ray Benson and his band Asleep at the Wheel, plus some of the original members of the Texas Playboys, are back. And they're keeping Bob Wills' memory and his music alive.
Some folk call her Dinah, stole my heart away from me. We're down in Louisiana, take me back to Tulsa.
The first job I played with Bob was at Trianon in Oklahoma City. Bob had a big band, not a good band, because he didn't have good musicians, you see. Well, he didn't know. He knew what he was wanting, but he didn't know how to get it. He wanted a good sounding band, but he had bad musicians. And it's like he told me one time, he said, people would ask him, he said, what do you holler? Bob, why come you'd holler between these tunes? He said, well, I'll tell you what, the musicians were so bad, I had to do something to cover up their bad playing. And that, I guess that's a true story.
Well, Shamblin ought to know. He played and arranged for Wills during the band's peak years. And as much as anyone, he is responsible for Wills' Western Swing sound. Rolling Stone magazine has called Ellen Shamblin the world's greatest rhythm guitarist.
Come in here, Leon.
As I look at the letters that you wrote to me.
Leon Rausch was a latecomer to Will's band, joining in the 1950s, toward the end of their glory days. He remains the Playboys' last great vocalist.
That to me were so sweet, I remember our faded love.
Every night was special with Bob Wills. Every night was different. You played your arrangements. You know, you had your you'd start at 10 with the two fiddles, the three fiddles, and you'd have your guitar work that was arranged. But when you got your solo, you were flying solo. And everybody in the band was that way, so it was exciting at all times to me.
Well, Bob started, what, 60-something years? Doing the same thing he did then. Maybe improved on a little bit better instruments, a little bit better amplifiers, but it's still the same result, and we're proud to say we're still continuing on.